King Rupert Productions. And out there, we have Mr. King, yeah, together. And guess what? They're gonna help you guys with several things. One of the things is gonna be, you know, voice techniques and a little training and talk to you about some things because they're success. Right now, your goal is to progress and to be a success in whatever you do. So that's part of your idea too, just to see other successful people. So, to, you know, to get something out. Okay? So I want you to give me your attention. I might go out of some money.
First of all, again, good morning to everyone. Can we, everybody, move to the center?
Can you
move
down one so I can see my
name? Yes, I want to thank you all for coming out. You know, how the morning is for a lot of us. And again, my name is Walter the King Wolf. I am a graduate of the 4-year. My degree was in elementary education. I'll call you an education major. So let's do this. Let's do a little exercise. We'll start from my right, your left. I want you to introduce yourself.
My name is Ernest Johnson.
My name is Victoria Truss.
I just thought you were going to call me DJ. My name is Sarah Grandson.
Great. My name is Montrevious Smith.
My name is Marticia Mazzy.
Great, great. Everybody's band?
Yes.
Pretty much? Okay, cool, cool, cool. Have you all ever sung?
Yes.
Yeah. In the shower?
Yeah,
close
to me. Everybody say play over here.
One at a time.
I said, fellas, everybody has sang once, multiple times in their life. You're not singing publicly, you're just singing.
I do. And well, us four, we sing all the time.
I'm always singing.
I was singing outside. That's just in my demeanor.
Like, yeah. That's just me, music. Everything I do revolves around music for some odd reason. It's like a switch you can't turn on.
So music is a part of us, even whether it's voluntarily or involuntarily. Music is that one thing, I tell people in workshops all the time, music is the one thing that we use our entire brain for. The one and only thing we use your entire brain for. That's why music helped ADD, you know, a lot of kids that has learning disabilities and things of that nature. Music helps repair those cells. My text today is to talk about vocal technique. So it's not just singing. Speaking versus singing. And feel free to ask questions at any time, because that helps me help you all. How you introduce yourself distincts you from the next person. The reason why I ask you all to do that exercise where you introduce yourself, your name is something that you know you've been saying all your life. But if you do it timidly, that speaks about your personality. Like all through school here, I always introduce myself as, my name is Walter the King Roper. So quite naturally, people, one, they think that's not my real name because I say the King, but that's actually my name. Secondly, the teachers and the students like, okay, you think he's somebody, then he's the King. I feel like I am somebody. And that's how you all should feel. Mr. Brown was making a reference about Mr. EJ here. When I initially, when he introduced himself to me, he had a little weak tone, you know, more like slurring, you know, saying like he was on the block or whatever. You know, that's cool when you're in that setting. And then he came back and reintroduced himself with a great level of confidence. And you all displayed that when you all introduced. The way you introduce yourself tells a lot about you. Speaking versus singing all deals with four different elements. Okay? When you're singing, the elements that you're kind of looking to, you think about your breathing, your dynamics, your posture, and your tone. When you're speaking, is more related with the resonance of your voice, relaxation, your rhythm, and the pace. You know, like I'm speaking now, whether you notice it or not, it's very short phrases, it's not choppy. Very smooth, because in the English language, that's more pleasing to the ear. When you think about people that speak Vietnamese, and Chinese, they actually speak Choppy. And since we're all music lovers and band, what's the term, what's the musical term that talks about Choppy or pulsated? Anybody want
staccato?
Staccato. Again, that was a musical term, but even when you're talking, I won't talk to you all like this because you all will think I'm a robot. Staccato. The other musical term, where everything is long, is what?
Legato.
Yeah, yeah, you're like, okay, okay. Cool.
Right.
So legato, of course, long phrases. And not a lot of pauses, a lot of stops. So again, as you're speaking, you want to make sure you pay a lot of attention and a lot of emphasis on those vowels. One, when you pay attention to those vowels and extend them, it helps people to understand what you're saying. And also a technique there, you flow into your words, so you smoothly go into your words. So, let's talk about resonance real quick, and I'm gonna just kind of just give you the points. Y'all wanna, I don't know if y'all wanna take notes in your phone, if y'all wanna write down, it's okay. If not, y'all just can listen, however. You know, some of y'all might wanna take this and use it. All right, so the first thing I wanna talk about in speaking is the resonance. The resonance is the quality of the sound of your voice. The quality of the sound of your voice. So, a lot of times when people are speaking, have you ever heard somebody talk like almost talking through their nasal passage? It's more like this, like the Steve-O type thingy. That's more the higher tone, and when you're speaking through your nasal passage. So, then you think about like when you EQing on your radio or your speaker, that's more like the higher tone, the higher frequencies. Okay. Then the next one is when people talk more so muffled, when they talk in their throat, like that, you know, their tongue is like in the back of your throat, and it's more muffled. Can't really understand what they're saying, but it's still the sound and the quality of your voice. And that's the lower tone, it's the lower tone, lower frequency. When you're speaking, you want to find a nice medium. It's like when you're balancing your sound on your studio, I mean in your stereo. You want to find a nice frequency in between your highs and your lows, which is normally, you know, a naturally talking sound. You know, there's a little exercise that you can do, and I know we just woke up. So everybody, let's just take a, no, you eat, right? You could. Everybody just yawn. I was like, I mean, you do that. Everybody. Again, right again. That tone, as silly as it sounds, as silly as it is, that's where you want to speak from. When you're, hello, how you all doing?
Good.
When you all yawn, that's a nice medium and a nice comfort place when you're speaking. Right there in that range. So again, the resonance is the quality of your voice. Secondly, relaxation. You want to make sure you relax. Because when you're not relaxed, your voice tends to get tight. It's tense. So definitely, and of course that comes with sleep. You're always talking about sleeping, resting. All that plays a part. It's like before you take a test or anything like that, you want to make sure you get a great amount of rest. Whatever it takes for your body to recharge, sometimes people need 7 hours, sometimes people need 4. Me personally, I'm usually up all night and up all day. So 2 hours to recharge, I'm good. That's just me. It's not healthy. But I'm trying to retire at 35, 32. And the way the plan is looking is is pretty close. You know, I'll sleep later. Sleep when I die.
Gee, I'm trying to sleep now and when I die.
So definitely, relaxation. So the first thing, your resonance. Second, relaxation. Make sure your voice is not tense. Make sure you receive the proper amount of breath. All right, third thing we're gonna talk about real quick is rhythm. How smooth you talk. Again, we kind of hit on that earlier when we talked about legato and staccato. Normally, when you speak, like I say, to the English language, it makes it smooth when you kind of slide into words. Short phrases, but slide into words. Like, just say, for instance, the word bus stop. Now, of course, if I'm talking to an elementary class, I'll say bus stop. But in a presentation, I'll say bus stop. I've just combined it. Again, I'll be choppy, systematic, robotic. I say bus stop. Staccato. Staccato, bus stop. So even when you're talking like I'm talking now, sliding into my words, very short phrases, but make sure my tone is not nasal, not too low, great frequencies in between. So the rhythm in which you speak. Another thing we want to talk about, fourth, in terms of speaking, is the pace. The pace. How you speak, when you speak. And again, when you're breathing, you have to be careful. You know how I don't know if you all like swimming. It's a great exercise for breathing. You know, of course, swimming will get you using all your muscles about. But it helps you to breathe. It helps you to breathe. When you're talking, you don't want to extend your phrases where you're using one breath to get all of these words in there. Because if you try to cram your words, you're gonna get out of breath towards the end. And then when you get out of breath, just like singers, when you hear them getting out of breath, the color of their voice, it kind of diminishes. And the tone of their voice diminishes because they're trying to get to that last, you know, trying to get the last little words out. So singers have to be conscious of how they breathe, and also playing an instrument, same thing, right? If you can't be strong on that note when you're playing, you know, and you ain't got but a little bit of breath left, you know? And, right, and your note becomes flat and all that good stuff. Really, what instrument you play?
Oh, saxophone.
Yeah, so definitely, you gotta make sure you take in the right, a good amount of breath before you speak, before you sing, before you play your instrument. Because you want to make sure you keep the color of that note, color of the tone, without losing. Just a quick stop. A lady just came in, Miss Jones. Everybody look back. This is Miss Jones. This is another instructor at King Roper School of Music. And she's actually a graduate of Judson College, music major. There in Marion. So this is another instructor of mine, along with Mr. King. She teaches piano and drums as well. Also some other instruments. What was your instrument in college?
Saxophone.
Saxophone. Okay. So again, the first thing that we talked about was the resonance. Quality of the sound. Secondly, relaxation. Be relaxed. Be tense. Thirdly was the rhythm, the pace. And fourthly, as I said, was the pace. Pace yourself. You know, I know being in college, we have to do presentations, you know, all the time. So when you're presenting, pace yourself. Command and demand the room. If I was just kind of speeding through everything, you know, everybody would probably be locked into, hey, I'm ready to go, on the phone, whatever, whatever. But again, when you're presenting, you want to make sure it's pleasing to the ear. So make sure it's short phrases. Slide into your words, though. Make sure it's not staccato. Because you don't sound robotic. So that's when you're speaking. When you're speaking, you want to definitely address those four elements. Very briefly, we'll run through the singing aspect. I know a lot of y'all say y'all only sing like in the shower and things of that nature.
Oh, yeah.
Y'all probably sound the best in the shower. The four elements that you want to talk about, that we're going to talk about in terms of singing again, is breathing, dynamics, posture, and your tone. Of course, before we even address those things, always warm up. Always warm up. Singers have to warm up. Instrumentalists have to warm up. Don't take that lightly. I'm a praise and worship leader, and usually, if I have an early service, 8 o'clock, on the way to the church and getting dressed, I'm warming up. I sound a mess, I'm cracking, you know, voice is waking up, but I'm warming up, I'm stretching my vocal cords out. I'm singing as high as I can. I'm singing as low as I can. So when I get to service, I'm already warmed up, so vocally, whatever I'm singing, I can, you know, use my range, whether my upper register or the lower register. But if I just woke up and jug in the church and try to sing some of these high songs that we sing in worship, I'm just sounding a fool. And I have to just Kirk Franklin my way through it. And I just talk it. Let the congregation sing. You know, so I just kind of meander my way through. So again, work on your warm-ups. There's a lot of warm-up techniques, whether it's scales, you know, all your, a million different scales you're going on with. If you're a percussionist, working on your paradiddles. Percussionist? Okay. Are you practicing? Yeah. All right. All right. And again, same thing with speaking. You want to make sure you rest and you sing before you. Don't eat too much. Sometimes people say, I got to eat. Don't eat too much, because that could create a hindrance. create a hindrance in your performance. Sometimes you may be sluggish and you eat, you know, too much. Right, that's true. A bad habit that singers have, they like to eat peppermint and eat candy while they're singing. That's a very bad practice. Why? Because at some places where you need to sing, you're gonna want to chew. Or you're gonna want to swallow. And I tell my people, whether concert, church, praise team, these are little kids, the little tiny top. Fall out, drag it to the side and keep singing. After this song, though. Because, again, that's a bad habit that, you know, they got from somebody else. So make sure, even with your instrument, I'm pretty sure, same thing when you're playing, you know, your instrument. Like, you gotta eat. How you gonna blow and eat? That's just terrible.
Hey, you know what? I done learned a lot over these
movies. Really?
Don't do it.
And lastly, make sure you drink water. Drink water. That hydrates your vocal cords, keep them lubricated. You don't want to be dry mouthed when you're trying to play an instrument or even trying to sing. So definitely keep some water with you. You know, even sometimes A practice that I... Ma'am? A practice that a lot of people tell us to do when before we sing or something, to relax. Say, okay, just take a deep breath. That's okay. What that does, it helps calm your heart rate. It's not really good to really calm you down. But what you should do, take a sip. Drink some water.
Don't, hey. I saw your face. I saw your face go there. I seen the shift.
He told me.
Drink some water.
So water is a great suggestion. Some people do tea. The first element we're going to talk about in terms of singing is posture. We'll kind of hit people. Posture, I'm going to kind of bounce back and forth, of course, to instrumental since you all are in the band. Posture, of course, we know is great. We don't want to stand, you know, to the side. You know. Usually, a great posture is you want to make sure your feet shoulders apart for our singers. I'm pretty sure the same thing for band. One foot slightly in front of the other, slightly in front of the other, gives you a nice little balance. Because you don't want to lock your legs out. That kind of leads you to falling out. So, you know, slightly bent, one foot slightly in front of the other, shoulder width apart, great posture. Keeps you level, balance, okay. Posture. Even when you're sitting. Great posture when you're sitting. Let's go to the edge of the chair. Both feet on the floor, planted. Torso straight. Even when you're playing your instrument, whatever you're playing, even percussion. So great posture is the first element. First off, any questions thus far? Okay, cool. Secondly, breathing. Again, like I spoke about in terms of speaking, singing and playing an instrument is breathing important. Same thing. Make sure you breathe. Do you all do breathing exercises?
Yeah.
Yes? Mm-hmm. Oh, hand raised is her yes. Kind of. You just make your breath. Okay, we're gonna do a simple breathing exercise. Metronome on your phone?
Yeah.
Let's partner up. So YouTube.
I ain't getting about okay singing.
Wait, don't worry about singing. We're not gonna sing. It's just a breathing exercise. Put it on about 95. So everybody's partner?
Yes, we are.
Come in. Bring it up. So your partners. So what about? So y'all just got nothing?
No.
Partner, who's your partner, sir? This is your partner. Who's your partner? Your partner. Okay, cool. Okay, this is the exercise. Everybody listen to the metronome. Can everybody hear that? Alright, everybody count to that. I'm gonna count to you in one measure and then y'all count with me. Here go 1, 2, 4 times. So
Taylor. Really?
Really?
Really? Okay, 1, 2, ready, count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3.
All right, wait. This is the exercise. This is the exercise. I'm going to count you in one measure, but when you're counting, I don't want you all to count 4, 4. I want you all to continue counting. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But this is the catch, all on one breath.
Okay.
All right? Now, you gotta, with your partner, remember that time. So when you don't cheat, because you're only cheating yourself. You're only cheating yourself. So then this is a great exercise. You coming up? Okay. And we're at 95 BPM. Nice, comfortable time. Everybody ready? Good. I'm going to count you in one measure, 4 times signature. But when you all count, continuously count. Okay? Ready? All on one breath. So when you stop, just remember your number, and then we'll wait till everybody is done. So when you're done, hold your hand up so we make sure you're right. Hello. Here we go. 1, 2, ready, count.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40.
What was your number?
44, 48, 42.
I got 42. She stopped and pushed the shit.
I promise you, I didn't cheat.
I don't believe you, Jay. He laughed. It stopped at 40.
What's
the
number?
I'm in the
28. 28.
I can't. My voice is cracking.
20. 61? Okay. All right, let's try it again. Again, same exercise. We're at 95 BPM. So everybody got to count. When you're finished, after you breathe, hold your hand up so I can make sure everybody does. So what we're doing is... So you count. Yes, but it's a great, this is a breathing exercise. And you can do this in your car. When you're driving, riding, while you're driving. But this is the game. Whatever song you may be listening to, oh, your conversation is pretty good. Whatever song you're listening to, you gotta lock into the beat. Okay? So. Here we go. When you all stop, remember your number, and then just hold your hand up, and then we'll make sure everybody does. So I'm gonna count you in one measure, and then you all begin on the down on the one. Can everybody hear? Pretty good? 1, 2, ready, count.
42.
I'm dying. 40?
Oh, cool. 42.
28.
So again, this is just a good breathing exercise for, you know, I know she sings in the choir. Are you in the band too? What's your name?
Harris.
I know she's in the choir. So this is a great breathing exercise. And of course you can get a metronome app from, you know, it's free. Just listen to that BPM, whatever you set it on. You may set it to 100 or whatever. Of course, if it was faster, we've got higher numbers. But while you're doing these breathing exercises, the catch is do it on one breath and don't cheat yourself. So some of you all, I think everybody, I heard somebody cheat, but a couple of y'all was breathing.
Yeah.
But this is the thing. I think everybody got a higher number than the first time. And that's the way you can gauge your breath. That's the way you gauge your breath and your breathing. Your breathing. So breathing is the second thing. Again, that's a great exercise. You can, like I said, you can use it with a song or whatever. So those little exercises. The third thing is tone. We're talking about singing or whatnot. Is your tone, the quality of the pitch. Now speaking, you know, we don't really worry about tone. Not, you know, it's not a big thing when you're speaking. But when you're singing, tone matters, because you gotta, especially singing, you gotta sing on pitch. Sing on pitch, as you know, you're playing an instrument, if you're playing a F and somebody else is playing a G, it's gonna sound flat. Somebody's gonna be a half step up, or a whole step, rather. So, tone matters when playing an instrument and when you're singing. Let's see how far off we are.
Just
tell
me to sing the alma mater, so you'll find out really.
We're working on it.
Everybody listen to me? No, we're gonna do it on an ah. So this is what you'll see. Ah, on me, on me. This will be your cue. Okay, on me, listen to it. Everybody sit up. Okay, now. Here we go. One, two, ready, sing. Good. Let's try another pitch. Whole step up. One, two, ready, sing. Let's do one more. That's a whole step up. One, two, ready, sing. Tell me what was the difference in terms of the sound in the male voices, some of the male voices, and the female voices.
Some people get a brass type sound.
A brass type sound?
Bass. Oh, you know what I mean.
Correct. So tell me this. Even though they sung a lower note, said a... what was the word you used?
Bass.
Before that.
Bass. He didn't gotta do this. You know what I mean?
So even though they had a more lower tone, did we sing the same note?
Yes.
So if we sung the same note, somebody sung it higher, and some sung it lower, what is that called? An octave. Everybody know what an octave is?
I know. Right? I just seen.
Okay. An octave is, somebody want to explain? So what?
Ernest.
All right, so.
Drum major, sir.
Is when you have the same note, but at a higher, lower pitch.
Correct. So y'all understand what he's saying?
I wish I had.
Let me bring my diagram. Where's it? Oh. So again, just to reiterate. All right, all your conversations. Just to reiterate what he said. An octave is how we explain it to our kids. It's playing the same note or singing the same note in a different place on the piano. Obviously, this note is called C. Everybody see the two black keys?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This note is C. Two black keys. This is the same note. Different place on the piano. That's called an octave. Okay? Ms. Harris? Got it?
Mm-hmm.
Same note, different place. So that's what an octave is. So sometimes they may sing, ah, but Lord, same note, different places. So that's what an octave is.
Is that what?
Mm-hmm. Question.
Is that why on the saxophone it has an octave key so you can make it higher?
Saxophone question.
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, correct. So, good question. You said you could add a little bit. Great question. Any more questions? Okay, last thing in terms of singing is dynamics. Dynamics is that thing that we use to enhance our performances. Of course, we use, you know, in looking at music, we see dynamic marking. Would you snare?
Two.
So, when you see those dynamic markings, it lets you know how, are you gonna play loud? Are you gonna play soft? You know, will there be a tie in there? Would you connect the phrases? Is it gonna be loud? Is it gonna be very loud? Is it gonna be a crescendo? A decrescendo? Is it gonna be, you know, mezzo piano? So that's like mid-range. So the term, let's do this song. Crescendo, what does that term mean? Anybody?
No, it goes up. That means the crescendo is down.
Correct.
Crescendo is up.
So a crescendo is starting from a point, and it gradually gets louder. Crescendo, gradually louder. For the symbol, you know how you.
Tick tick.
Right. So and it gradually gets louder. And a decrescendo is the opposite. When you start from a point, and then it gradually. That's a decrescendo. For me, let's do forte.
Loud.
Mezzo forte.
Medium.
Piano.
Soft.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Soft. Fortissimo. Sorry. Yeah. Very loud. So when I was playing, let's take this intro.
Put in my song.
So if we was doing that bigger song, like we'll start at the. It gives a totally different vibe and a totally different response from the crowd. Same thing when we sing. Same effect. If you want the crowd to move a certain way, your dynamic marking. Even when you're playing, you want to get a different reaction from the crowd, you gotta play a certain way. So again, just in conclusion, speaking versus singing are one and the same, but the four elements are different.
when you're speaking, the important elements are resonance, relaxation, rhythm, and pace. When you're singing, the four elements you really want to pay attention to is breathing, dynamics, your posture, and your tone, and your tone. Again, I'm Walter the King Roper. If you have any questions, feel free to contact me through the website. Give us a call, text, however. Any questions though before we
shut up? Ready? So, all right, here we go. Ready, 1, 2, 3. One more, 1, 2, 3.
Listen, thank you for